I want to film a quick intro before we get into today's video. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my current makeup collection slash inventory. I figured while I'm sharing with you my makeup collection, I can just do my inventory with it since I'm going to be pulling everything out category by category. So I am at our lake home. I have been working from home here for pretty much all year since of, you know, COVID. That is my silver lining. But I wanted to share with you my current like makeup setup. It's not my normal one because I don't have my vanity here, but I've made it work. So I'm going to flip you around, share with you kind of my setup, and then we're going to get into the actual like counting of makeup, and I'll share with you everything I have. So I am going to leave timestamps down below of the different kind of parts of this video. If you are more interested in maybe like eyeshadows instead of lipsticks or whatever, you can jump around that way. But yeah, I am super excited to share with you my current collection. So let's just go ahead and dive right in, shall we? All right, so this is my current setup. I have this like bench by the floor that I've adopted as my little makeup desk. So right here is my mirror that I'm using. And then I have my current makeup basket right here, which is nice because I can just pull it forward and dig through this throughout my kind of get ready experience. And then I move over here. So I have this little box, which has the perfumes I've selected. I will have my makeup basket linked down below for you, as well as a backup powder, because I'm working on finishing one up. So this is what I will use next. And then behind that, in this like decorative box, I have all the makeup that I'm not currently using right now. So I have it kind of stashed in there. I do have this red box too. I don't have anything in it right now, but if I needed to reorganize, I have a second box that I can use. And then I've got my brushes and my beauty blender and my cheat sheet for my eyeshadow roulette. So I just keep track of each color that I'm supposed to be using and the tallies. And I've just got a couple of pens here. So that is the like setup. I'm going to be pulling out all of the makeup by category and placing it onto the table. So we'll be looking at it kind of from a bird's eye view so you can get a good idea of what I have. But this is the current setup I have. So give me a minute to get all set up and we'll go ahead and dive right in. All right, so we're going to be starting with face products. And what I have right here are my face primers. So I've got three currently. I have the Too Faced Primed and Peachy. This is my favorite primer. However, Too Faced is discontinuing it. So I am kind of waiting for a sale to maybe pick up one more. But I do have these two from I Heart Revolution. I picked up the Peachy Delight and the Strawberry Whip because I thought maybe the Peachy Delight would be a close dupe. It's actually the Strawberry Whip that is more close to the Peachy Too Faced one. Go figure. But they are all geared towards oily skin because that's what I have. So these are the three primers that I'm starting the year with. And I do think that I'll be able to finish a couple of them up throughout the year. Next, I have my foundation. So I currently have three foundation products. The first one is my CoverGirl Clean Matte BB Cream for Oily Skin. I love this product. It's a perfect medium coverage foundation slash BB cream. It feels really lightweight on my skin. And I've gone through a couple of them. I just love them. Next, I have my CoverFX Custom Cover Drops. This is great for mixing with samples or anything like that. I am not counting any of my samples. I do have a couple of these Fenty sample cards, but unless if they were like minis, I'm not going to count them. I do count minis as their own, but something like this on like a paper sample is not going to be included. But yeah, this CoverFX Drops is great for mixing. And then I also have the CoverFX Power Play Foundation. I am currently working on finishing that one up. Next, I have concealer. I currently have two concealers. So I've got this one from Essence and this one from e.l.f. The Essence one is the High Beauty Under Eye Brightening Concealer. It does have a little bit more of a peachy tone. And then this one is the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. And I have the shade Fair Beige. This one is a little bit newer to me, but the Essence one I've had for a while. All right, next I have powders, and I currently have five powders. So I have this one from NYX. This is the finishing powder in the shade Translucent. And I do have a significant amount of pan on here that I am going to be focusing on finishing this one up in the year. The next pressed powder I have is from CoverFX. And this is in the shade Light. This is a powder that I have in my purse typically, but since I'm not going to work, which is where I would use this to touch up, it kind of has gone by the wayside. So I do have a little bit of pan in here, but this is the powder I typically would have in my work bag. Next, I have this Hourglass palette, and I am counting each product in here as their own category. So this is a quad. However, it does have a powder in it, and this shade is called Soft Light, and I do quite like this underneath my under eyes when I'm setting my concealer. So this powder is being counted as an actual powder. And then I have two of the Too Faced Peach Perfect powder. These are my favorite powders. Again, Too Faced is discontinuing the peach line, but I have only used about half of this one, and this one is completely full yet. So should be set for quite a while, but with my oily skin, I do love a good powder. Moving into bronzer next, I have two bronzers. So again, I have my Hourglass quad here, and I do have the bronzer shade right here. And then I also have this e.l.f. Primer Infused Bronzer, which I do have some pan on. I have been using this as my main bronzer for all of 2020. Next category is blush. I have two blushes, and they're both from Hourglass. So again, I've got my quad here, and I've got this blush shade down here. And then I also have this mini blush that I have been working on for the past year as well. This one is called Mood Exposure, and I do have pan in it, which is very exciting. All right, next is highlighters, and this is the last time I'm going to be mentioning my Hourglass quad. So I do have a highlighter in here, down here. And then I also have the Laura Geller French Vanilla highlighter. I am almost done with this. This is a baked highlighter, so there's really not that much product left in here. And lastly, I do have this Milk Makeup holographic stick that I do from time to time use as a cream highlighter. I have setting sprays. I currently have two. So I've got the Rose Wet n Wild setting spray and the NYX Bare With Me setting spray. I do prefer the NYX one over the Rose one, but the Rose one is a little bit more hydrating, which is nice for the winter months. All right, next we're going to be moving into eye products. And the first eye product I have here is my eyeshadow primer. This is from Milani, and it is the only eyeshadow primer I currently have. The next category is cream eyeshadows, and this is the only one I have. It is from Supergoop, and it is the shimmer shade, and it did come with SPF 30, though I do believe the SPF is now expired. But it's just this kind of nice, neutral, bronzy, gold kind of shadow that looks really pretty in the summertime. For single powdered eyeshadows, I do have one. It is from the Ulta house brand, and it is in the shade White as Snow. I do have some significant dip in here, and this is the go-to shade I use for setting my eye primer and kind of cleaning up any sort of darkness around the outer corners. For eyeshadow palettes, I currently have five that vary in different sizes. I am counting even like these quad as a palette. But these are the five different eyeshadow palettes I have. So the first one is this Anastasia Quad. These are four singles that I put together in a quad, but I am counting this as an actual eyeshadow palette. So the shades I have in here are Pink Champagne, Ballet, Bonfresco, and Dusty Rose. The next eyeshadow palette I have is the Anastasia Soft Glam 2. This was new to the 2020 holiday season. So this is a smaller take on the traditional Soft Glam eyeshadow palette. And the eyeshadows are here. So there is a good range, and it is a little bit of a warmer kind of purpley toned eyeshadow palette. The next one I have is from Kylie. I've never had a Kylie product before. This is my first experience. This was a set, so it came with two eyeshadow palettes in the holiday season of 2020. I gifted one of them that was a little bit more warm, orangey toned, and I kept this one, which is a little bit more cool and rosy toned. So these are the eyeshadows that are in the palette. Pretty neutral base. There are six of them, but I think it makes for a nice little quick and easy kind of palette to use. Next eyeshadow palette I have is my Anastasia Sultry palette, and this is one that I am definitely going to be using and abusing this year. I have really grown to love this eyeshadow palette. So these are the shadows in here. I have completely finished up Fresh, and I do have Pan on the shade Pearl here, and then I am working on some dips in the other shadows currently. And saving my favorite for last, this is the ColourPop Bare Necessities palette. If you follow my channel, you know I can't stop talking about this one. But these are all of the shadows, so it comes with 30 eyeshadows in here, and you do get a variety of textures, of finishes, of shades. There's definitely cool tones, warm tones, rosy, kind of more red down here. So a lot of good variety in here, which is what makes this the perfect neutral palette for me. So those are all of the eyeshadow palettes that I own. Eyeliner, I currently own two. They are both from NYX. This is the NYX Super Skinny Eye Marker, so it is a liquid liner. And then I also have this pencil in the shade Velvet, which is kind of like a gold bronze pencil eyeliner. For mascara, I currently have one, which is the CoverGirl Exhibitionist Mascara. I have grown to quite enjoy this one, but I also really enjoy the Essence Lash Princess mascara line as well. For brow products, I own two. I have a pomade from Milani that I have been working on, and then I also have a brow gel from Essence. This is the Make Me Brow, and it comes with this super teeny tiny brush. It is a tinted brow gel, and it also has fibers in it to make your brows look a little fluffier. So between the two of these, I can get exactly the look that I'm going for. Now we're going to be moving into lip products. So I have three lip liners, a variety of tones of the same color, I would say. So this is the Jordana Easy Liner in the shade Tawny, which is kind of like a brown nude. I have the NYX lip liner in the shade Natural, which is a little bit of a lighter, rosier nude. And then I have the Ulta lip liner in the shade Spicy. This was from a collaboration, and it is a berry shade. Moving into lipsticks, I have six lipsticks in a variety of formats here. So I've got two on the end that are more of a pencil kind of crayon formula and format. This one is from Ulta. It is the Velvet Matte Lip Crayon in the shade Terrestrial. It is very true to the shade that you're seeing on the cap here. This next one is a ColourPop Lippy Stick in the shade Trust Me, which is a red and is very true to the stopper color that they have on the bottom of the packaging. Next is my Bare Minerals Liquid Lipstick in the shade Boss, and this is a really pretty, like, kind of brownie nude, but kind of pulls more of a plum pull to it. The next one is the Flower Beauty lipstick right here in the shade Cinnamon Crush, and it's pretty true to the color of the sticker on the bottom. Next we have the Ulta lipstick in the shade Nude, and this is one of those perfect my lips but better type of shades that's very comfortable to wear. It is a pretty creamy formula and easy to pair with any eyeshadow or, you know, cheek kind of look. And the last lipstick I have is a mini from Bite Beauty in the shade Chai, which is a deeper berry shade right here. Lastly, I have two lip glosses. I have one from NYX in the Butter Gloss range, and this is the shade Creme Brulee, and I have a Fenty gloss in the shade Fussy. So that is going to be it for my makeup collection January 2021. I hope you guys enjoyed. I have a pretty small, manageable makeup collection, I would say. I do have enough variety for what I'm looking for, but I'm very pleased that it's not overwhelming or to the point that it once was years ago. So thanks again so much for watching, and I hope you guys will subscribe, and see you guys in the next one. Bye.